Hello everyone, today I'm gonna show you a really simple tutorial on how to create this curved page that you can see in here. It's really helpful when it comes to presentations, thumbnails or markups. So we're gonna see how to create it. So I'm gonna create a new file. So I'm gonna go to file, new, and in the width and height you can choose whatever you want. So I'm gonna press OK. And now I'm gonna change the color of this background. So I'm gonna create a new solid color. And I'm gonna choose this dark gray in here. And I'll press OK. Let me just delete this one. And I'm gonna start making a curve in here, as the page will start curving from here like this. I'm gonna go to the pen tool, and in the pen tool, make sure it's set shape in here. Alright, I'm gonna start making a point just right around here. Alright. And I'm gonna make another one just right here. Let's say just right here. Alright, now if I want to change the replacement of this point, I can just press Ctrl and, you know, move it where I want it, just like that. And also, if I want to change the replacement of this handle in here, I can press Alt, and as you can see, I can change this like that. Or, you know, if I want to change the curve of this line, I can just press Alt and, you know, make it even more curvy like this. All right, now I will make this point a little bit just right here. Make it just right there. Alright, and I'm gonna make another point in here just like that, and then we're gonna close it right here. Alright, now I'm gonna press Ctrl T, and I will make it a little bit bigger, just like this. Alright, and in here too. And I'm gonna press Enter. Now we need to create another shape that will go below this shape in here. So I'm gonna go and change the color to this blue. I'm gonna change the color of this one to this gray, like that. Alright, so I'm gonna start from here, as I want to make this shape go with the curve of this one in here. So go just like that. I'm gonna start trying to make it as curvy as this one. All right and I will just close it. It doesn't need to be perfect because it would be below this shape in here. All right and I will make it under this one in here, and as you can see, we start seeing the effects taking place in here. Let me just change the color to this grayish color, maybe. Let's keep it blue. All right now we need to apply a shadow to this shape, first shape that we created, and a kind of light reflection to it. So we'll go and double click, and the layer side dialog will open, and I will go to the gradient overlay in here. I'm gonna change the colors. I'm gonna change this black color to a softer gray, 70% black in here. And I will press OK, and I'm gonna take this white color and put it just next this gray, a little bit like that. And I'm gonna make a new color in here by just one click and change it to a 70% black like this. And I will press OK, and I will move it to to be next this one, like that. And we press OK. Now I'm gonna change the angle of it. Just right in here, it will look perfect. Alright, I think it looks good. I'm gonna make the opacity a little bit down, maybe around 70% or 75%. Alright, it looks good. Now we'll go to the drop shadow and I'm gonna uncheck use global light, and we'll make the opacity around 50%, and I will make the size bigger like this, and I will try to replace it just like this. We'll make the size even bigger, just right there. And there you go, we have our curling page in here. Now let's say we want to apply the same curl to another project we have, so we can easily do that by just, you know, let's say make a new file, change the width to 1920 and the height I will choose 1080, and I will press OK. Let's change the color to this gray color in here like that, and now I can just easily just make everyone in here in a group and then just drag it to this project in here, and I can just press Ctrl T, and you know, you can even make it as big as this, or you know, you can make it smaller and make it in the right place you want to make your project like that. And there you go, we have a page curl in here that we can use whenever we want. Alright, so I hope that you like and you enjoyed this tutorial and it was a little bit helpful for you. Don't forget to subscribe and comment and you know, wait for more tutorials to come, and have a nice day. Thank you for watching.